Camps. So but we haven't had one for a bit, so Muswellbrook was one as well. So we're moving our way through, Lizzie. So that is a real challenge for the trainer.
Do you like Bruce? You're always a little bit quiet with your tips.
I like euphoric. So up comes that stageman. So he should know better than a 9-year-old. So
I thought it was euphoric. I heard you were tipping it.
Well, that would happen to me, Richo.
I tell you what, I've had a euphoric moment today with Pride of Jenny. Look, let's pause for one sec. There's a lot of disquiet about the jockey's tactics behind Pride of Jenny today. And we got that with Chris, with you, no doubt, that frustration. And James McDonald, I know it's been tweeted embarrassing. So, you know, we had a situation many years ago where Scotch and Dry did something similar, and there was a big blue at Flemington before your time, guys. So, you know, whose responsibility is it to take the horses up to Pride of Jenny? Good luck.
Yeah, well, it was the perfect storm, Bruce, because the horse that was following, Craig Williams put Mr. Brightside in. Now, Craig would have ringing in his ears all the owners complaining about him being too warm in the Australian Cup and eyeballing and getting too close to Pride of Jenny. There's no way that he was going to be taking the others up to Pride of Jenny. It needed another jockey to take off and try to catch her. Keep in mind, she ran 202. She didn't run too flat. She ran 202. Exactly. So there'll be a few jocks thinking we got that really wrong.
And Buckaroo missed the kick. Now, he's not a forward horse anyway, but that was the idea. At the 600-metre mark, Pride of Jenny was 106 metres in front of Cascadian.
Wow.
Who finished fourth in the race.
I give you this, though. She wanted to be there. Deck didn't put her there. She wanted to be
there.
She
did the same thing at Royal Randwick last year, didn't she? She took off. Here's the golden mile.
Got nothing, Duck.
They are ready.
Still got nothing. You're right, you're
they stand right. Well, Sabath a little bit toey, racing now. Macram the last out, Euphoric second last away. Just Folk began quickly to lead from Rolls, Bell, Placier and Sabak. Golden Path got to fifth, and then came Sir Davy El Soleado's trying to find a position four deep. Frankie Pino next the inside midfield from Foxy Frieda, and then stage man T. Waters Euphoric. Well back Macram with also second last in the race, Wild Planet. And at the tail of the field, Tara Mansour at the 1100 metres. From the outside alley, Just Folk took it up by two lengths to Rolls. Speed around the outside from Bell Placier, improving its position. Sabak is on the leaders back at the 900 metres. They're about a length and a half. Sir Davy on a limb from Golden Path and Frankie Pino. Then came El Soleado. Next is Foxy Frieda, stage man T. Waters, Euphoric, well back Wild Planetara, Mansour and Mac Rahm. Just Folk is the leader. Has a breather at the 650 from Bell Placier. A length and a quarter, Sabak and Rolls. They were followed by Sir Davy. Golden Path in sixth position, about four off the lead. Back behind them, Frankie Pino. And then came El Soleado. Foxy Frieda dug up. Stage man's held up from T. Waters. Euphoric looks hard at it. And they were followed by Tara Mansour and Macram. Just Folk off the rails. Still led at the 300 metres. By a length and a half, Sabak, Bell Placier, Frankie Pino, Rolls. Golden Path under pressure. And then El Soleado. Just Folk below the 200. Sabak is grinding away. And stage man up on the inside. Just Folk's vulnerable. Sabak's got it with stage man. Bark and El Soleado's flying out wide. It's close. El Soleado. El Soleado's got up to win from either Sabak, Just Folk and Stage Man in a four-way drive. Behind them, Foxy Frieda. Next to finish, Frankie Pino and also Tara Mansour. Euphoric and then Bell Placier. Back behind them, Rolls T. Waters, Golden Path. Then Wild Planet, Foxy Frieda and Sir Davy.
So a couple of flops in the race. So you can come with a big rush today, Richo. This horse is giving them a big start. This is great for Robbie Laing, great for Patrick Maloney. You can see Pat there. It means a whole lot for him. He's had a terrific campaign, and he's been a big part of Robbie's, I guess, re-engagement with the sport, don't you think?
Yeah, revitalisation, yep. No doubt in that. And Paddy Maloney's been injured and been out for a long, long time, so he's back. That's why he would have said, you'll beauty, winning a listed $200,000 race. Photo for second, third and fourth will be really interesting. The roughie Sabak gave us some sort of sight, didn't he? He came up on that inside.